better at integral. Okay, so just to remind you, substitution rule, which I've written down here, says that the integral from a to b of f of u of x times the derivative of u is equal to the integral from u of a to u of b f of u du. Right. Of course, the assumption here is that the functions f, u, and the derivative of u are all continuous. And otherwise, those integrals may not make sense. So, let's apply that theorem to this integral. So, what we have to do here is we have to decide. What are we going to pick as our u? Well, if we look at this integral, you see we have cos of x squared times x. So if you differentiate x squared, you get 2x. Right. So what we have here is more or less the derivative of the inner function here. Now, of course, minus the factor 2. But that's okay. You can always bring that in later. So looking at this integral and thinking that I want to apply the substitution rule, I would pick u as x squared. So let's see. If I make u equal to x squared, right, then u dx will be 2x. Or then x is a half du dx. But if we substitute these expressions into our integral, then we see that I is integral from 0 to root pi cos of u of x times x, x is a half du dx. Yes. So what we have there is exactly the left-hand side of the substitution rule, with the function f here being replaced with cos. So the cos function is the function f here. And so now applying the substitution rule, well, the substitution rule says that this is now integral equal to the integral of the integral just of cos of u du. And remember, we have to change the bounds of integration as well. Here we integrated from a to b, and here we integrated from u of a to u of b. So u is x squared, so if x is 0, u is 0. Right, so our lower bound of integration is 0. Right, and when x is root pi, then u being x squared will be pi. There we go. Which function we have to pick to be u. So next, we'll look at something a little more challenging.